Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. You've just landed in the second episode of 6, developing plugins for Qt Designer. I'll start out with a small cartoon I drew myself. It looks like this. Initially, life was good. I was happy. Then one day, I had a problem initializing my widgets, those that I was using Qt Designer, either as plugins or just as regular promoted widgets. Should I use a setup method? How about a zero timer? A show event? What should I do? I couldn't find a good solution. See me? That's me. So then I thought, yes, I will make an episode for Qt Widgets and More, because that's where all the good solution comes. Well, that's what you're looking at now. The application that I'll show you here is rather simple. You can see it on the screen now. We have 3 checkboxes: Candy, Depeche Mode, and Eternal Life. 3 different things you may wish for. And they are checkboxes with green background. It's not entirely unlikely that you have something like this in your application. And let me just show you what it looks like. My wishes here is constructed in my main.cpp. In real life application, it would be much more complex. But at some point I thought, I want these wishes in multiple places. So let me create a widget with those wishes in. And the widget, I'll give it a bunch of parameters in my constructor, specifying different things. And you can see here's my wishes subclass in QWidget. It has a constructor that takes an isExclusive Boolean and a color. And you can ask for the names of those wishes as a string list. It has the buttons inside it as a vector. And here is the implementation for it. So I'm creating a layout and I'm iterating through these 3 things here. If it's isExclusive, if this isExclusive Boolean parameter is specified, then I'll create radio buttons. Otherwise, I will create checkboxes. And I set the autofill background so that we can actually see the color. I set the blah, 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 usual stuff for getting the background colored. And I set the color of the background to this color that came in up here. I add the button to my list, and that's it. And if I want to know the names rather than getting those names, I go and ask for the text of those buttons. Come on, Jesper, that's a silly example. Well, is it? Don't you have lots of widgets in your code where you specify a bunch of parameters to your constructor? If I want to make this widget a plugin, either promoted or real plugin Qt Designer, then I need a constructor taking only a QWidget parent. But where do I call the setup method then? Well, how do I specify the colors and so on? Let me show you my first suggestion for a solution to this. On the screen, you see my what to wish for dialog now. It's a client of that wishes element. So you can see they are radio buttons now. And in here, you can see my wishes is a promoted widget. Let's look at what wishes.h looks like. And I defined this particular version. I simply took the setup and moved it into a separate function called setup. And it takes the regular parameters as before. And the body of this setup looks exactly like it did in the constructor before. My client.cpp code looks like this. It's okay. I have my UI that I set up like this, and I call wishes setup true comma green. It's okay. Yeah, it's okay until the day when it's not okay. The time when you forget to call that setup method, and either the user interface shows up weird or it is in some broken state. So can we do better? What do I say? A zero timer, what an excellent idea. Not, but let's see it nevertheless. So you see the user interface on the screen. Now the colors are, I don't even know what that color is, cyan, I guess. And they are radio buttons. It's just to have a bit of a change of scenery here. what you really should be looking at on this screen is this line here saying QTimer single shot 0, comma this, comma setup. What that means is that after 0 millisecond, that's not right away, that's as soon as we get back to the event loop, then 0 millisecond after that, we will execute the setup method. And the setup method is therefore guaranteed to be executed after my constructor is done. And, well, I would like to say before anything else, but that's the problem with this. See, my setup method is definitely called. It looks good, right? And God knows, I have done this numerous times myself, but I also burned my fingers numerous times myself because the widget, until that timer fires, is in an intermediate state. Let me show you what client.cpp looks like. I call my setup here, setup UI. I no longer need to go and say UI wishes setup. I just set it the color to be CN. And then the zero timer will go off. I couldn't set the color in the constructor because the constructor is run on line 32, or, well, later, but from between line 32 and line 33. And the cyan color here, therefore, has not been set yet. But the zero timer guarantees that all of this will be done executing, then the timer fires and my code executes. But let me show you the run output here. The application output, you can see a very beautiful open parenthesis, close parenthesis. That's actually a list. It's a list of strings. See, qdebug wishes pointer names. But at this time, my zero timer hasn't executed. There are multiple variants on how you can burn your fingers there. Let me make you a beautiful drawing here so you can see exactly one of the places that has hit me multiple times. So our code is executing along here. At some point, we decide that we want to create this zero timer. And remember, a zero timer means that it goes off after 0 millisecond. But of course, that's not right away. An event will be put into the event loop or into the event queue. And then the event loop will pick that out as soon as it can, giving you the feel that it's after 0 milliseconds. So I continue on here in my execution of the code. My event loop start running around. That's my while true loop. My event loop calls one very crucial method, namely process event. I'm not going to type that out for you here. And then something might happen in there. And who knows, at some point I might actually get into a situation with an error. So there's an error condition here. And as a result, that piece of code might bring up a dialogue saying, blah, 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 something really bad happened. Do you want to continue or cancel or whatever? So there's an OK button here. The intention of that OK button is, of course, that the user should click on that one. But for Qt to be able to take input events onto that button, it needs to start another event loop. So here's another while true. And it called process event here too. And it's waiting for keyboard input and mouse input and whatnot. But it also looks at the event queue. And at some point, my timer is at the front of the event queue. My timer goes off. Hello. And now the code that is connected to that timer gets executed. But the question is, this code here that gets executed, did you prepare that code to be executed even in situations where an error has happened? Likely not. Maybe this code tried to do something with the user interface, but it can't because we have this modal dialog. You see, this is a really nasty and tricky situation. The best I can say is, no, thank you. Please do stay away from zero timers. They have never, ever done any good. Well, in a few cases, they have. But most of the time, when you think zero timer, do think again. Okay. So a zero timer, I hope I convinced you, is a bad idea. the solution that I finally came up to was to use a dirty flag so that the widget do not need to have a setup from outside. It, on the other hand, do not have the problem that there are certain methods that I cannot call until something else has happened. Let me show you the code for this. So I've now extended my wishes just a little bit. I can now set exclusive and set color as I could before. And in each of those methods, I call a method called setDirty, which marks that that some properties of the widget has changed. And then whenever I wanted to reach into it and fetch data from it, I can call this ensureInitialized method. And the ensureInitialized method then sets it up, calls the setup function if it hasn't been called already, or rather if it is not, or if it's dirty. There's a few more things to it. So let's look at the setDirty first of all. It sets a dirty flag, and then if the widget is already visible, then it calls ensureInitialized. So I'm changing the color and the widget has already been shown on the screen. Then I call the ensureInitialize to reset up the scene. The ensureInitialize, if it's dirty, then it will take my wishes and it'll cast that into a, well, it'll cast away the constness because ensureInitialize is usually called in getter methods and they are const, so I'll cast away so that I can call the initialize method. And then I will mark it as dirty. Finally, the initialize method also needs to be extended just a wee little bit. This is what it looked like before, but I need to be able to tear it down. So I go and delete the layout of the widget. I delete all the buttons in there. I clear the list of the buttons, and then I execute this stuff here. Unfortunately, all of these three things up here are perfectly valid to call even when I'm initializing it the first time. There's one thing left, namely the showing of the widget. Whenever I set a bunch of things in, at the very last thing, I want at least to have it initialized whenever it's on the screen, which is what the show event does, ensure initialized, but it only do so if the event is not spontaneous. Spontaneous events are events that Qt itself, or your application at least itself, has not started. So when you call show, then it is actually not spontaneous. But if the widget is shown from the X server, then it is spontaneous. So if it's not shown from the X server, which would happen, for example, if you move to a new virtual desktop on your Linux, well, X server, Windows server, whatever. But if you're on Linux, moved from one virtual desktop to the next, then it will actually be called show and spontaneous. So not spontaneous, ensure initialized. That was the final solution. And I actually liked that very much. And I started rolling that out in my own code base. And I had that problem when I created designer plugins for my own widgets. That was one thing I didn't like about it though, was that there was a bunch of code that would be repeated again and again for each widget. The ensure, initialize, the show events, the set dirty, and so on. So I thought, I can do better than this. Let me show you. And this is exactly what better than this looks like. It's a base class. It's a template type name base. So I don't know if it was always QWidget. It could be QFrame. It could be something completely different. So I can specify the base class using the template method here. And it's delayed initialization widget. And it uses the default constructor of the base class. Set dirty, just as you saw before. Ensure initialize, just as you saw before. Initialize is a pure virtual method. That's the one that I need to implement in each of the cases. And then again, this show event here, just as before, which means that my wishes.h now looks simply like this. All I need to do is to subclass from this delayed initialization widget with a QWidget instead of just subclassing QWidget and implement this virtual method initialize. The initialize method looks exactly like it did before. And now I just need to call setDirty in each of the places where I'm actually changing things. And I need to call ensureInitialized whenever I want to go and read a valid state. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. In the next episode, we'll continue with our quest of creating designer plugins. The last piece that we need is to take your application, make that into a library. Until then, do leave your comments below and stay safe and stay sane. I'm Jesper Pedersen. I don't know what else to say. Goodbye.